In this illustration, we'll analyze the case of pushing a cylinder in a liquid. Here we are given that a solid cylinder of density rho is floating in a liquid of density sigma, which is greater than rho, and the cylinder is having a cross-sectional area S and length L. And here a buoy pushes the cylinder down so that it will completely submerged in the liquid. We are required to calculate the work done by the buoy in pushing the cylinder. So, here in the initial situation, one cylinder would be floating in a liquid. We can draw the situation and we can see in the floating state, say the cylinder is submerged to a depth h in the liquid. Then here we can write in a state of floating of cylinder. Here we use the buoyant force acting on the cylinder is V rho of liquid G should be equals to M G, where M is the mass of the cylinder. Now in this situation, we are given that the cylinder length is L. And if we consider it is submerged to a depth h, and its cross-sectional area is also given to us as S. So here the volume of submerged part we can write as h s multiplied by density of liquid is given to us as sigma multiplied by g is equals to the mass we can calculate as ls total volume multiplied by rho density of solid multiplied by g. Here S and G gets cancelled out and this will give us the submerged part of cylinder within liquid and this H is equals to L rho by sigma. Now in this situation, if we further push it down by an external force, we can write if cylinder is pushed down slowly by a distance y, then external force on it is given as, here we can write if it is further pushed down by a distance y and save this the state when cylinder is submerged to a depth h plus y. Here I am considering it is further pushed down by a distance y from the state of floating. Then in the situation, this force would be balancing the buoyant force minus the weight of the cylinder. So we can write in equilibrium, we use here F plus mg should be equals to h plus y multiplied by s sigma g. So in this situation, this mg and this hs sigma g gets cancelled out. And in this situation, the value of force will get as s sigma g y. So this is the force acting on the block, cylindrical block, and slowly pushing it down when it is submerged to an excess depth y beyond the equilibrium depth when the cylinder was floating. So we can now calculate the work done in pushing the cylinder completely is, this work done we can write integration of f dy. And we integrate the value of y from 0 to L minus h, because initially y was 0 and the total depth which is to be submerged in the liquid is L minus h. So in this situation, we write it S sigma g integration of y dy from 0 to L minus h, and this will be S sigma g multiplied by this y square by 2, that is L minus h whole square by 2, that is the result of this problem.